everybody. Welcome to the I Spit on Your Grave panel at Fan Expo. My name is RIchard Crouse. I'm a film critic for CTV's Canada Oct and their TV channel. And you can listen to my radio show, which is about 10:10 every Saturday at noon. If you don't like it, I want to welcome you to this. And we're going to kick things off with a look at the original film. We're going to have a look at the original trailer. And it'll sort of, for those of you who haven't seen the film, it'll give you an idea of the tone of what we're going to be talking about. So let's have a look at the first one. That was the original trailer for I Spit on Your Grave. The DVD will be released by Anchor Bay sometime in the very near future of the original film, so keep your eye open for that. A couple of things I should also mention before I show you the new trailer and bring up our special guest is that as you're going out, everyone will be given a ticket, and if you want to have an autograph from one of the cast members or the producer, Lisa Hansen, you'll be able to redeem that ticket upstairs at the Anchor Bay booth for an autograph. So we won't be doing it here because we have to get out of here to make room for the next show, but you can go upstairs and get it down there and you'll be given priority. Also, this event is being filmed, as you can tell by the multitude of cameras around me, so your voice will be recorded if you ask questions later on, so just keep that in mind. Right now, let's have a look at the new trailer for I Spit on Your Grave, Redux. It's opening October 15th in Canada, and for any American friends we have in the audience, it opens October 8th there, so it'll be playing in a theater near you very soon. We're going to bring up some very special guests who have come in all the way from LA to join us. Our first guest is Lisa Hansen. She is the producer of I Spit on Your Grave. She has executive produced or produced over 70 films. She gave Robert Englund his first directing gig and also hired Quentin Tarantino for his first ever writing gig on a film. Would you please help me welcome Lisa Hansen? Our next guest is Jeff Branson. He plays Johnny in I Spit on Your Grave. You've seen him on Law & Order, SUV, Strangers with Candy, Without a Trace. He's appeared in the film Shaft. Here he is now. And we also and finally joining us is Sarah Butler. Sarah Butler has worked on CSI both New York and Miami. She's bi-coastal. A web series for Fox and another project from the writers of Prison Break. I Spit on Your Grave is a remarkable performance from her, so I think let's welcome her to the stage and we'll get started. So we've got some more film clips and things to show you, but Lisa, I want to start with you. What was it about the original film that made you think that it was ripe for remake?
Well, it's one of those movies that sticks with you for a very, very long time after you see it. And we felt we could update the film, still do the original fans justice, update it and do it well. Do it as good as the original, if not better. And that's the only reason we approached doing it.
And what was it about this material? I mean, when you first saw it, when it came out, the original film came out, Roger Ebert most famously really slammed in his review, and probably in a matter of speaking, made millions and millions and millions of dollars for the filmmakers because he made people want to see it.
Absolutely.
What was your, when tell me just about the first time you saw the film and what it was that sort of grabbed you?
Well, I'm just curious, how many people here have seen the original film?
Wow.
Oh, all right, great. That's great. There are some unbelievable moments in the movie that you just, you don't forget. I don't want to give too much away for people who haven't seen the movie, but there's a reprieve from the assault on the lead actress. And you, for a moment, think she's actually going to get away, and she walks into a scene, and the guy, Andy's there playing the harmonica, and there's like these fantastic moments like that that are just great, that are really great. And there, it certainly was groundbreaking cinema in its time, and it showed a woman really taking action on her own behalf, really getting her revenge, and that we found really, I personally found that really compelling.
And Sarah and Jeff, had you seen the original film before you were approached about doing the remake?
No,
I wasn't either.
No, but the audition, we I think both auditioned, we came in several times with the director and the producer, and during that process, I had to watch the original film just to, if you read the script, when we went in for it, if you read the script, it was red hot. You kind of wanted to know a little bit more what you're getting into. And then I watched the original before, I think before the last audition.
Yeah. We also were a little sneaky. We initially released this script as Day of the Woman, because it wasn't as, it was the original title. It's the title that to this day Meir, Zarchi prefers. But we wound up going out with releasing the script with Day of the Woman just to, you know, try and make sure we got a broad audience of, you know, broad people coming in, a lot of actors coming in.
That's how the breakdown read, Day of the Woman, but thank God for Google.
I wasn't smart enough to Google it.
And Sarah, what did you think when you first read this script? What was your initial reaction? Because you go through a great deal. I was going to say, I don't know, words like punishing come to mind. I mean, you know, I have to wonder, what was it about the character and this film that made you go, you know what, I really think it's, this is something I want to do?
Well, I can't say that was my very first reaction. I think initially reading it, I shed tears, and I thought, why the hell did my manager make me go on this? And then I kind of realized, and with the help of others too, that this was actually just such a great role for an actor. The character arc that I got to go through was just like incredible. It's how many emotions I got to portray, and I think for an actor that's a dream role. And especially because I come out the victor in the end. And
you've just given the end of the movie away.
Sorry guys, forgot to do the spoiler alert. But yeah, it and actually my manager, he's usually very protective of me when it comes to especially like nudity and stuff like that. So I called him and I said, oh my God, did you read this? Like, and he was like, oh, well, let me read it. I'll get back to you tomorrow. And I thought for sure he'd call back and say, absolutely not. But he actually said these were his words. He goes, Butler, you have to do this because you're going to be so badass. And I think he's right.